Good morning, students. So before we're going to start the discussion about the Pandora's Box, what comes first to your mind when you hear the word myth? Is it folklore? Gods and goddesses? Perhaps men and animals? What about legend? Supernatural figures? Stories or narratives? Symbols? Fantasy? And history or origin? So with these words, we will know about the definition of Greek mythology. So what is Greek mythology? Greek mythology is the body of stories concerning the gods, goddesses, heroes, and rituals of the ancient Greeks. So in the popular piety of the Greeks, myths are viewed as true accounts. It has actually an extensive influence on the arts and literature of Western civilization, which fell ear to much of the Greek culture. Moreover, Greek culture is also a group of stories that are often told by the ancient Greeks to their families and friends over many generations, based on the fact those gods, like men and women, could also be punished or rewarded according to their actions. So the ancient Greeks used myths to help them understand what is really going on around them, such as the forces of nature. So I have included here this words, so the sea gods, woodland gods, the sky gods, underwater gods, half gods, and human heroes undertaking courageous and romantic adventures. So later on, we will know about the connection of these words that I have mentioned in the Greek myth of Pandora's Box. So after that, we have known this definition of Greek mythology, we are now going to talk about the Greek myth of Pandora's Box. So this story or myth of Pandora's Box is actually slightly unusual among the Greco-Roman myths, especially in terms of its origins. However, in the Greek didactic poet, his name is Hesiod, this myth is told unto us through a poem which was composed in around 700 BC. So Hesiod then is our source of this myth of Pandora's Box. This myth continuously inspires new poetry nowadays. So according to this myth of Pandora, this story is considered one of the most descriptive myths in Greek mythology. So the ancient Greeks used this myth of Pandora not only to instruct themselves about the weaknesses of human, but also to explain several misfortunes of the human race. So according to the myth, the first woman on earth is Pandora. So he or she was created by gods as a punishment to the mankind. So how does this story reveal that Pandora is a punishment to the mankind? How is it possible? So each god gave her a gift when they put Pandora into this world. So thus, her name in Greek means the one who bears all things. So her gifts were beautifully evil, according to Hesiod. So how is that possible, right? So Zeus wanted to punish the people because Prometheus, the god of the fire, stole the fire to give it to them. So Prometheus here showed too much affection in helping the people. That's why Zeus made a trick to chastise them, and that is through giving them Pandora and her box. Besides, Hephaestus created her from a clay, shaping her perfectly. Aphrodite also gave her femininity, and Athena taught her on how to make crops. However, Hermes, ordered by Zeus to teach Pandora on how to be deceitful, stubborn, and curious. So did you see the differences of those gifts that the gods had given her? So did you still remember what I told a while ago, that Pandora was given a box or a jar which is called Phaethos in Greek? So in the first place, the gods already told her that that box is contained with special gifts. But she was not allowed to open it forever. So how would you feel if you were Pandora? You were given a box that is full of gifts, but you were not allowed to open it forever. Wouldn't you be so curious for a lifetime? Oh, I too. So, in line with Pandora's box situation, we can see the reality of life. And like Pandora, we are given a box and that is our future. There may be lots of uncertainties that is being given unto us, but we can trust that God is always in control about many things. So we can take everything unto Him and believe that He can turn those uncertainties into life certainties. However, in this myth of Pandora's box, we will see how this reality is being manifested. So Hermes took Pandora to Epimetheus. So Epimetheus is the brother of Prometheus to be his wife. So in the first place, Prometheus already told Epimetheus not to accept anything from Zeus. But when Epimetheus saw Pandora, he fell in love with her beauty. So that's why he accepted her and became his wife. So by and by, Pandora was trying to tame her curiosity about what is really inside the box that the gods had given her. So at the end, she could not tame his or her curiosity. So she opened the box. She opened the box, and then all the evil, the illnesses, the hardships started to coming out. So when she saw the box as being opened, she was scared, and those evil spirits started to coming out around her. And then she tried to close the box as fast as possible, and then closing all the hopes that is inside her. According to Hesiod, hope also stayed inside the box because that was the will of Zeus. So Zeus wanted to let the people suffer because they wanted to realize that they should not disobey their gods. So Pandora was the right person to do it. Why do you think she is? Because she was curious enough but not that malicious. So this reminds us that evil and hope really exist. And there is always hope when we choose to believe, trust, and obey unto the Lord. And know that we are created in this world because God has a purpose. That's it. And not for us to live independently, but fully dependent unto Him. And recognize that God is always in control about many things. And know that He has the power, He has the control over the people. And the main purpose of this myth of Pandora is to address the question, why does evil really exist in this world? All in all, this story of Pandora's box depicts how we are all created by God with a free will. And like Pandora, we are to be shaped. We are to be molded by our God. We too have limitations. So we fall and we fail by the deceitful ways of the evil and to the temptations offered by this world. But God gives us a choice. And at the first place, He warns us and instructs us through His words. And it only depends unto us and how we heed unto Him. May we, like Pandora, choose to follow and obey what the will of the Lord is. That's it. Do you have any question to ask? I think you're all ready for an activity. So our activity for today is entitled My MV of PB Tech Story. So you are going to create your own story of the Pandora's box through writing a prose poetry. So you're going to make your own catchy title for it and create a creative graphic illustration for your modern day Pandora's box. So remember, you are only allowed to do the activity in a day. If you exceed on the given time, your scores will be deducted. So you're going to submit or post your output in our Google Classroom on or before the deadline. And be reminded of this criteria. So, content and organization, creativity and originality, vocabulary and grammar, as well as the date or the timely submission. So, I'm going to add plus 20 points for those catchy title for your title. So, that's it for today, class. And thank you for cooperating with me with this Greek myth of Pandora's box. I hope you are all doing fine, and do not forget also to put into action what we have learned today. Thank you.